At times, I'm fairly pessimistic about the damage we've already caused. The language should no longer be preventing climate change. It's more of a damage limitation exercise now. There are far too many companies whose economic interests lie in the past, and they're unwilling or unable to reimagine a future. And there are different opportunities. Renewable energy was seen as a sort of premium or expensive option. At scale, it should be the cheaper option.
I was very intrigued. I thought, well, this is interesting. You know, you get a car that you can use for energy storage and then providing back to the grid. I've got solar on my house as well, so I thought this would be quite interesting. I like my technology, I like my gadgets, and I thought, well, this is a perfect stepping stone to get involved with electric vehicles. For me, it was more about the technology. Now, for my wife, it was more about being green and reducing carbon footprint. So this was the kind of equal balance of everyone, you know, getting what they want, really.
Long term, it's going to, if everyone sort of carries on like this, it's going to be better for our environment. This is all like contributing towards helping us to have like a much more healthier, cleaner planet.
For 150 years, you know, we've been able to dig up coal and oil and gas and burn that as a very high energy source. But we now know that when we do that, we are releasing carbon dioxide, and that is causing the greenhouse effect and a warming of the planet. The important thing is that we all need to move towards leaving the remaining fossil fuels safely buried underground. We need to find sources of power that are not burning fossil fuels from underground, therefore sustainable for the long term, but they're also clean. They're not going to generate carbon dioxide and other gases which cause health issues. The trilemma is, how do we make the supply of energy affordable, sustainable, and reliable?
The energy industry is evolving probably at a pace that we've never seen before, because so much is dependent on technology. And more citizens across the globe are needing better, more reliable access to energy. It's not the most intuitive that data and climate and sustainability are linked, but they are inextricably linked. And that data is going to come from traditional forms of fuel and energy sources, but at the same time, how it interacts with newer forms of distribution and electrification, electric vehicles, how we're tying into solar facilities, how we're tying into wind farms. You need all sorts of organizations to come together to solve this big problem of meeting our current energy demands, but also helping to transition to a more sustainable energy future. So you have big companies, multinational, global organizations that are starting to develop new innovative business models, make investments in new fuel sources. But it's also these upstarts, these new organizations that are also tackling it from a very different angle.
Octopus is a group of companies. We are an original energy retailer. We exist to bring innovation and technology solutions which can help people save money and to reduce the amount of carbon they use. There is a wholesale price of energy at different times of day. It actually costs more to buy energy at times when there's lots of demand. In the evening time, when people come home from work and want to use lots of appliances in their home, it's more expensive. We burn fossil fuels at the evening peak in order to meet that demand. With a vehicle-to-grid technology, we can take energy out of a car battery at that time and actually support the grid, reduce the amount of fossil fuels we burn, and so make it cleaner and greener to use energy in the home at that time. Power Loop project is a great example of a technology which can help people save money and to reduce the amount of carbon they use.
It's a very clever system. It's very easy to use. you just state how much charge you want for the next day, and the car will automatically manage how much to discharge and charge up for you.
He has a car that can do exporting of energy from the battery back to the house and the grid, and he has a charger which can enable that as well. And then the final piece of the puzzle is that he has the PowerLoop app, which runs on his phone, which allows him to schedule when he wants his car back in the morning and how much charge he would like in the car. And then the rest of the system runs automatically. Within Octopus, we use AWS to host our Kraken platform. Kraken is our customer management system. So it really underpins all the elements of the back-end system and the apps that we're using to help customers not only understand their energy billing, but more and more to control their EV charging. So it really is the technology behind the technology.
Hey, Ben,
how are you doing?
Good to see you.
Good to see you as well.
Let's go inside.
Claire, this is my wife, Reshma.
Hi, Reshma. It's really nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you so much for having me.
I find, especially when you've done the times slots, then that makes it much more easier for us to know exactly when to put the car in, when to put the tumble dryer, washing machine, dishwasher on timer.
And do you time your devices to come on overnight? You do?
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, that's great. We really need these technologies to help us balance the grid and to use and store energy when it's green and cheap, to be able to then use that at times when there's extra load on the grid to avoid burning fossil fuels.
The kind of innovative tariffs we're offering now say to customers, let us control when your car charges. So we can not only be responding to the demand of when customers are needing charge, we can be directly influencing it through price incentives. On the generation side, we know when there's likely to be excessive capacity or spare capacity to be using. Within a day or two's notice, you've got a pretty good forecast as to what power you're going to be getting. Solar power is available when the sun's shining. Wind power, only when the wind's blowing. Where we'll use data is in both forecasting the available power, but also trying to shape customer demand so that we can balance the generation of renewables with meeting the needs of customers. You start to get a very different way of balancing the grid, and it's a way which really is going to work far better with optimizing the use of renewable sources.
With this wind farm, there's thousands of data points being collected now in terms of production, how it's tying into the grid, and it allows for real-time optimization for how you're actually procuring renewable energy and how that ties into natural gas and other sources of energy.
But as we start to see different parts become smarter, it means that each part of that system is starting to be able to interact with other parts to understand and monitor where energy is needed and where it is actually being produced. Bringing together EVs with electrification of heating technologies, as well as things like solar and battery, we're starting to see all of these technologies coming together to make a super smart energy home of the future. And that's what gets me really excited. My eldest child is nearly six, and they've got a really good grasp already on how energy is produced, when it's produced cheaply and greenly.
Let's go.
If the young children can understand this technology, when they become adults, they'll be able to take things forward and bring things that we haven't even thought about today.
Do you want to open that up, girls?
I feel like we're building foundations now for the future. That's something definitely to be hopeful about.
We've actually made a shift in the way we use and consume our energy, because the way the pricing structure works, it incentivizes you to make those changes. I mean, it's going to be technologies like this that are going to solve these problems. Give it a decade or 5 years, this will become mainstream. These cars will become part of our energy system.
So that when I turn on the lights, when I turn on the TV, when I charge my car, I know that it's tied in to a more sustainable ecosystem. And these energy companies are now embracing it and making meaningful impact regarding it. And that's a big difference from what it was 20 years ago.
We're able to build new services supporting customers on the journey to a renewable future, doing our very best to look after the planet and prevent further climate change. If we can make a contribution to solving that, then it's a pretty worthwhile thing to be doing.